What up? What up? What up? Bankroll Tim bedded up. Let me walk over here and kill my number one fan. I was over here cleaning this shit up. All right, so you can see all this shit. Every bit of this right here is from the underneath of this car and the tubs. Boom. All this in here. So much heavy shit from the tubs. I'm an alcoholic, guys. Somebody commented on my YouTube that they think I'm an alcoholic. Oh my God, this is one tall boy. One tall boy, which is all I've had in a week. Or he didn't say alcoholic. What did he say? I'm a drunk. He thinks I'm a drunk. Boom. So there you go. That's how much of a drunk I am. The paint that I use, I had two cans sitting here and didn't realize I had it, but I had ordered four today and they didn't come in yet. But that's all good. It's all good, but just tons of nasty shit. I better stop fucking around in there before I slice my shit open. Because that shit's really fucking sharp. Alright, so. What we got up with this car? The tubs are fully done. I did undercoat. I did undercoat the tub, boom, 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 boom. They got some, you know, some heat wrinkles in them, you know, from fully welding. So now they're fully welded all the way around. You can see the shininess there. I went back over. I hate it. The filming is beautiful until I put my finger in and see how it blurs out. So the weld marks, but then I put paint over that. So with more paint, I already undercoat it, so I'm gonna put the undercoat over, or the paint over the undercoat, so it has the same color. This light right here is throwing shit off too. And it's shadowing, making it look like that's ground, but that's painted. Which I didn't have enough to, I'm gonna put more on that to get the coat that I want, the thickness that I want. But I went back over the brazing underneath here. Oh, look at that. I'm trying to use the phone to record. And now my mom's calling, but she's just going to have to wait. Anyway, so yes, the tubs are fully in there. I went ahead and I put the stocks, all four stock rims and tires and hubcaps and the stock jack back in the trunk because I want the weight in there to represent music or whatever. I mean, the four rims with the four tires are, you know, they're pretty heavy. I want to say sounds, you know, 212s, a box, a battery, whatever. You know, like 200 pounds. All four of those tires with the jack, and they might be somewhere right in there, but you don't have to be dead on, but on enough. So yeah, same thing with this side. The angle that we're looking, I mean, that right there is looking like it's wrinkled out, nasty as hell. But it's just this light, the ceiling light, it's just, it's making a shine. It's a little bit, but it's not as bad as it's looking right there at all. See, the higher up we go, you can see it's nowhere near. It's just got the undercoat on there, and then you can see how the paint is over the undercoat, so it's shinier than the undercoat. Anyways, look at that. I got a big nasty run right there. But yeah, tub, like I said, fully in there, fully welded up. So again, with the full weld all the way through, like in the car side, inside there, I mean, I fully welded every inch of it. There might be two or three pinholes per side that didn't get Yeah, see about that. Let me see right here. Now look at the toe. Because I'm black on light. So this angle right here, see how it's getting the shine off of the light? Anyways, something for somebody to pick apart, because they'll just look at it and then they'll just go off of what they saw instead of listening to me. So I got the tie rods. I remembered to get the tie rods today. And boom, it's all just setting together. Boom. The tie rod sleeve, and you can see I got dirt in it, I think, unless that's the color. Nope, it is a darker color. But when you put these on, you evenly put them on. You got left-hand thread and right-hand thread. Then, when you put this side in, you hold the center and turn, or hold this outside, so that one's already holding. You twist this until you line up. Then, once you're on the ground and you start setting the alignment and all that shit, boom. Look at that, black nut, right? Shiny nut zinc. Like, the inners are bigger than the outers. So it's not like I could switch them around. So, got the tie rods on there, boom. The sway bar links are sitting up in here. Well, one is, where the hell did the other one go? Huh. That's crazy, because it was in here. It's not in here now, though. But anyways, I'm about to set the height of the front end up a little bit, as in I'm going to twist that up, and the rear end. So, the owner said to go ahead and keep these wheels on here. Keep these tires on here. Like I was saying, I really wish we could have went to the smaller tire. You know, just from different brands, you can have the same number tire, but from a different brand to a different brand, one could be on the rim bigger than the other one, which this is a big, hefty tire right here, which I don't think I've seen anybody with this tire. So let's see, what's it say right there? I don't know what that says, y'all. Let's see if we can find another name on here. You know, they normally have like two names. Oh, there you go. So, and there's the number. What is it? 275-25-28-99. I don't like how square it is on the rim. You know, square. So it comes out a lot more. And then with clearing the chrome right here. But my custom alignments, like I've been saying, this is the old style. Upper, so I already took the ball joint, put it on underneath. The way that I have the shaft twisted up on the up top side, the tires are out when you put it on the ground, so I should be able to just shim the back, which will move the wheel back and bring the wheel in. But if I don't have those shafts twisted out, I could do that, or I could put a ball joint spacer in there, so that way I can bring the back of the arm back more. So degree steering, sport steering. So that from here, you know what I'm saying, we'll take this wheel and move it back and the top in. But you got to know all the measurements and shit like that. Not saying it's that serious. Anybody with a brain can do it. When I'm on my alignment plate on the ground, boom, I go to the bottom of the spindle right here. Both sides are the same. So off of my plate to here, let's say it's 14 inches. You know what I'm saying? And I measure that side and it comes out 14 and a half. That means that the driver's side would be degreed back more than the passenger side. So then I would move this one back to 14 and a half, and that would be by shimming the upper back of the control arm, which would bring this one back. So I got some basic numbers, you know, and let's see. 13 inch, 13 and something, 24s on these cars off my plate. 14, you know, it's basically an inch and a half difference per. So this one being a 28 inch wheel tire setup, boom, it's up there. 15, probably 15 on the degree, what I'm calling the degree, because it's laying the spindle back, which is bringing the wheel back. The brace, like I said, I will take the brace off I could probably take it off the top, and what I'll do is rebend it to where I'll hook it to here, drill a hole, boom, you know, make my own little tab, something like that. And then, like I said, you guys, that little 10 mil bolt that's right up inside there is a little 10 mil that bolts the outer to the inner. If you take that bolt out, you can pull your fender out without putting a crease in it. All right, so on to the rear end. This is what I was talking about the other day. You guys seen it sitting here, and it was the whole area right here where the control arm mount, everything was. So I didn't have to sit here and cut all that shit off and grind it. I took off right in the center of it because I needed 5.5 off of there. That's another thing I was digging for in here. So let me see. So now that I said I'll fuck myself up. Now I'll fuck myself up. You know, it's never where you want it to be. Alright. Oh, here we go. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, as you can see, the lower control arm mount, the shock mount, the rear cover. So I was able to take that whole setup. Let's try it for the other side. So I was able to take that whole setup right out of there. Like I said, people are like, oh my God, you're cutting that straight. Oh my God, you cut it crooked. Oh, wait. It doesn't matter. What matters is from here to the back side of here, see, the yellow's there. That's how I measured it. So my original was 19 3/4. And then what I took off was 5.5. So, boom, my number went from 19 3/4. See, overall, two, from that yellow line right there, all the way up to this one, 14 1/4. So, this area will be ground down and beveled. This side will be ground and beveled. The bearings will be knocked out in the seals. These are garbage, junk. I got new ones. Got the adjustable super drop boxes like that going on here, which will be the same width, like I was saying before. The car side from center to center is like 37 inches. So then this is 37 3/8. So it's just a little bit wider on the rear end side. And then there's still plenty of room here to fucking narrow it and all that. This one right here. I think these two rear ends come out. The axles that are for this one are 25 inches. And that axle is 25 inches. So these are basically coming out the same. Except that one being a G-body. This one being box Chevy, both 7.5. So I'm gonna get to cracking on this, get it all set up on this side of the bench the same way I got that one set up, and that way I can weld this one up and weld that one up at the same time. Then I can turn around and cut that one too. I mean, that one's good enough right now because I got a weld there. Those ain't welded to the bench yet, they're just welded to there. The bar behind there is to keep it all square. So I do the same thing to this one. So I gotta clean these up. I take these, set them in the vise, take the big ass socket in here, boom, hit it with the fucking hammer, knocks the fucking bearing and that shit out, which it doesn't matter how, even if I use a piece of pipe, because these bearings and seals are junk. Over the years and over the months and all the stuff and this and that. Let me show you. There is a whole bunch of bearings and shims and this and that. see these ones right here. How I got the zip tie through them. These are for a truck. So, because they're a bigger bearing, bigger center, boom. So, when I do change, well, I mean, they're for a truck, so whatever. Some seals, but that's a truck seal. And this one's a 7.5 seal. I keep all this shit, and sometimes I get to where I get so much of it. You know, you get basic shims like this that come out of rear ends, but so, it's good to have solid ones. And then you, different sizes, 240, 250,000, 230,000, whatever. Races, pinion shims, you know, shit like that. That's not it. That's definitely not it. So here, let's see. This kit right here is a 7.5. So 7.5 rear end, 82 to 98. But this one comes with the outer bearings, so, and outer seals, see, outer seal, outer seal, outer bearings. So recently is when I noticed these. So if anybody is buying the kit, you buy the whole kit, so that would be the whole kit right there. So that way you get these with it. And if you don't get them with it, then these are $57.07 at the store, and the seal is 8660S. But the bearing, the bolts for the gear, stuff like that. But anyways, another setup right here. So let's see. This is the pinion bearing. But this might be 7.5. Yeah, that's 7.5. But that's the outer side. Got another seal at 7.5. These are the center section bearings, which these, let's see, it might be 7.5, it might be 8.5, but this kit is, these are both 7.5. Some kits come with the gasket maker, some kits nowadays, like, see, this one doesn't come with it, didn't have it in there. Let's see, I got another one down here, 8.5, 7098. Let's see, what's it? Oh, nope, that's just extra shit, see. Tons of extra shit, extra pins. Here goes some. That's a goofy looking seal. That might be an outer seal though. It's just a different kind. And then, let's see. Another one right here, which this one says GM 8.5. Oh no, just extra shit. So yeah, see, this one is a 8.5. Nope. That might be 7.5 too. But a lot of extra shit. Never know when you're gonna need it, putting this shit together. But then sometimes you don't need it. So rear ends, car. This 9-inch, I gotta get done. I gotta get this 9-inch done. So as soon as I'm done with these two rear ends, I'll set this 9-inch up on there. And I gotta go through and figure out what I did. I made the long axle, the short axle. Made the short axle, the long axle, and I believe I took 2 inches off of it. And then I still got to take an inch off each side or 2 inches off each side, something. And then, of course, those buckles are coming off because it's got the super drops on there. Don't want anybody thinking that I'm using people's parts on other ones. Super drop boxes right there for that rear end. Super drop boxes right there for that rear end. This rear end right here has the super drop boxes. Right there, the control arms, all that, blah, blah, blah. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take the control arms. I got the frame rails painted. I'm gonna put the control arms up in the top. Boom, I'm gonna put the control arms on the car side. Bam, those can hang. And I'm gonna fab up the rear end. I got the brake lines for the back. I got the tie rods for the front. I gotta find that other sway bar link. I don't know why it's not sitting there. Maybe it's right here. No, you know what? I see this. Oh, yeah. No, that's not it. That's definitely a pack of studs, though. Half inch. A 3-inch, half inch, 20 screw-in studs. So, that works out good if the axle's for the dunk with the 2-inch are too short, then I can put those in there, meaning if I have the space to wheel out some. And then that also works for, well, it works for this car too. Well, no, this car has 3-inch half inch coolant studs, wherever the hell I put the axles. I think this is one of the axles, yeah. Boom, the axle right here. See, 25 inches. Boom, recondition, boom. 26 line, just for a 7.5 cruiser. This one later on, once he does the motor and all that stuff, we'll figure out gear and all that and what rear end he wants to step up to. But this rear end would be ready for somebody, completely ready for somebody to put in their box Chevy. All right, y'all, look at that. I tripped over a light that's turned on. I'm gonna get this cleaned up. I'm gonna go back there and I'm gonna fab up that rear end. Clean it up, fab it up, drill with the bristle head, clean it up. I gotta take the center section out because the bar goes in there. Again, everybody, with narrowing, this bar right here is a solid, solid, solid bar. This bar is from Mittler Brothers, along with, you got center pucks that go in here, main caps. You guys remember, when you take these main caps off, you set that main cap to the side. Even if you got to take a piece of cardboard, set it down. This one comes off on the right, put it on the right. This one comes off, goes to the left. I've seen these things come in. This thing will be flipped over. The lefts and rights will be backwards. The way all that shit's machined, boom. Somebody could put your rear end together and know how to space the gear and this and that. But then if they fuck up on the caps, that'll eat the rear end right up. 7.5s are very, very touchy rear ends. Very touchy. So pinion depth, the more shims you put behind the pinion bearing brings the gear back farther. So if you got a 410 gear and you bring it back too far, you'll see that when it's riding, the gear will actually end up with a little edge. Like it'd be a cut here and then come out because the pinion depth is too far in. So 32 is a perfect number on pinion depth with shimming. But some rear ends just want to be bitches and they just want to break and they just want to wear out and they just want to howl and make noise and stupid shit like that. But yeah, so I'm up in here, man, up in here, trying to get this shit done, I got the major thing done, the biggest major thing with this. I mean, I look at the other videos, I'm like, damn, you know, a couple weeks ago this, a couple weeks ago that, damn. But everything's moving along pretty fucking good now. So, I'll be here late, been up and about and out, and been here since like noon today. So, I am going to hit all this again. So, I think I'm going to hold off on putting the arms up in there because I want to paint this some more because that looks like it's folded over and it's not folded over. But I'm going to get some more paint in there and put the paint over the undercoating on the tub so it has that same look. Instead of that look, it has that look. And you can see since I've been talking about the run. So, let's see. You know what we'll call this? We'll call this custom. I didn't even realize when I was putting it on there. But it's because you're trying to get in between here to get, you know, in between the tub behind here, boom. And then you forget that you're hitting the edge. See, this way I can let it dry and then I can hit it with this cuff pad. And the scuff pad, I can knock it back down. Yeah, now to dry easier. The scuff pad, I can knock it back down before I put the final on there. I wish I would have caught it earlier, because if I'd have caught it earlier, I'd have done the Earl shot. I would have just ran it until it ran off. And then if it would have dripped, the drip would have dried on the bottom, and then I could have just cut it off with a razor. All right, y'all, this thing is moving right along. I don't see anything on here that I would end up having a major problem with. I know that the wheel, I'm still gonna trim the lips because the problem part, okay, I'm not cutting here, you know, you guys already know that. So that means this wheel is gonna sit back normally more than what everybody else, because everybody else cuts this, leaves the wheel forward. So with the wheel going back here, it's that outer part right there, you know? So I'm still gonna take the screws, move them out a little bit, boom, 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 and then trim the lip. Because, I mean, look how fat that lip is. And then you have the excess metal sticking out, you know? And then I still gotta cut into the black right there a little bit. And then when the rear end, you know, with how the geometry of the rear end is, where it sets, boom, and up and down in 3 inches, that rear end will stay. It doesn't move forward and back, forward and back. So I could be half inch. I always go half inch, you know? That's all it needs right there is a half inch of clearance. Sometimes I can get away with a quarter inch. But, all right, y'all, frame braced, frame notched, tubbed. Yes, it's been a minute. I can't wait to get to one car at a time. And I gotta clean up this shit. So, Angleton, bed it up. Bust my ass to get this one done. And then I can knock this one out real fast. So, appreciate y'all. There it is. Appreciate everybody. Subscribers and everything. And I'm out.